day, right here, right now, and claim it for you that in our combined face, which are different, we took different spokes to the center of this wheel, but the center of the wheel is where you are. We claim you as the victor for all of us and for all those who we represent. For the power that's been given me, Lord Jesus Christ, all that you have put inside of me. From you, Supreme Being, who took my father from me so I would never see him again, yet only see you, God, as my father. I anoint and I have blessed this man, Trey Halton, and I claim him for your kingdom. I claim his walk and his testimony of that which has already been written. From inside his mother's womb, you already wrote his story, and his story is immaculate indeed. That you give him the power of prophecy, that you give him the power to seal up and hand out, that in his sackcloth, that you see him as the lampstand, the olive tree, Lord. And that his word is identified as your word. God, Father, for those who are gathered round, Lord, may we stand in awe and witness of what you are about to do. That this has nothing to do with our flesh. This has nothing to do with our home life. This has to do with what you have already set in motion and claimed to be. That there would be a great and mighty nation that is to come that follows your word and your will. I specifically ask for a blessing for Jacob. Lord, that you grant him the mighty army that he needs around him, and that he be able to receive all the love and support that he comes his way already been identified. For Andrea, Lord, that you already know her heart. You know what it took for her to be here. She has her testimony linked with this, Lord, as this be the epicenter, the impact of the moment that Christ is born. Again, for all those who support us, for all those who watch around us, that they may see that, no, this may not be the fancy Taj Mahal, but as in the stable, a child was born. And as in this very place, this humble beginning, a spiritual birth takes place. May we strengthen one another and bring others to the fold to say now is the appropriate time. And we just say this in your holy and precious name, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So we're reading in the book of Revelation, and we're here in chapter 10, verse 7. But in the days of the sounding of the seventh angel, when he is about to sound, the mystery of God would be finished, and he declared to his servants the prophets. Just in that single verse identifies the bride church or the chosen church. One of the churches that gives this message is the church of William Branham. I'm not going to go through this. You can certainly go to, here in Arizona, Evening Light Fellowship and or Flagstaff Tabernacle. Those will be ventures for another day. But that is the church of Revelation 10. In chapter 11, two witnesses are given mighty power. Verse 3 says, "And I will give power to my two witnesses, and they will prophesy 1,260 days, clothed in sackcloth. These are the two olive trees and the two lampstands standing before the God of the earth. If anyone wants to harm them, fire proceeds from their mouth and devours their enemies. If anyone wants to harm them, he must be killed in this manner. These have the power to shut heaven so that no rain falls in the days of their prophecy, and they have power over the waters to turn them to blood and to strike the earth with plagues as often as they wish. When they finish their testimony, the beast that ascends out of the bottomless pit will make war against them, overcome them, and kill them. And their dead bodies will lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, where our Lord also was crucified. Then those from the peoples, tribes, tongues, and nations will see their dead bodies 3.5 days, and Allah allow their dead bodies to be put in the grave. And those who dwell on the earth will rejoice over them, make merry, and send gifts to one another, because these two prophets tormented those who dwell on the earth. Now, after 3.5 days, the breath of life from God entered them, and they stood on their feet, and a great fear fell on those who saw them. And they heard a loud voice from heaven saying to them, come up here. And they ascended to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies saw them. I want to just take that a little further to the amplified version from Jonathan Mitchell. He goes on a very interesting point that he brings up in chapter 11. He says, and I will continue giving my two witnesses. And they continue giving to my two witnesses. I'm sorry. And I will continue giving to my two witnesses, and they will be precede prophesying. That means that they were always been given to, and they've always been prophesying. So this is nothing new for these men. They're doing what they've always been doing. But now they have been anointed and been given supernatural power, blessed by God, to bring forth this mighty word. And he uttered and wondered.